This is a good place to start.
Of Bear Network News. I'm Akilah Bibbs.
And I'm Deysi Lopez. This BNN broadcast will focus on things to prepare us for the future, things that make us sick, and things that get us into trouble. Can you believe it's almost the end of the 9 weeks?
I know, right? Progress reports went up this week, and some of us really need to get it together. Your grades shouldn't look like this.
Mm-mm. Okay, let's say your grades look like that. You probably need to start doing your work, go to tutorials, and talk to your teachers about your grades.
But don't do this.
Yes, do you have a question?
Yes. What is this?
That's your grade.
This cannot be my grade, man! I worked hard on this!
Yes, but you didn't get everything right. Look at this. These are not right. You can come during lunch or after school to make it up.
No, man, it's my time. I don't got time to be wasting with you.
But then you failed my class.
You know what? Forget you, man. Forget you and this whole school. I'm out. I'm not coming back. I'm done.
Really? Not really. Is that how you act, people? Come on, let's try that again.
Yes, do you have a question?
Yes. Why am I feeling great? What did I do wrong?
Well, you did these right up here, but down here, it wasn't right, so that's why I put needed improvement. But you can come out to school during lunch or some other time, some other free time you have, and you can make this up, and they'll put
bump the grade up.
Okay.
So if you want to come, you can just sign
in
right
here.
Yes, you can do both. All right,
cool. Can I do it today after school and tomorrow for lunch and after school?
Yeah, that'd be fine.
Alright, cool.
Okay, I'll see you.
Alright.
Here's something to think about, Hastings. Life is 10% what happens to you and 90% how you react to it, by Charles Swindle. Sometimes we just chill out and stop overreacting to everything.
School a few weeks, but there are still a few issues that need to be addressed. Here are a few reminders.
All right, Hastings, this is your girl Edgewell with a few rule reminders. Case, whoa, that's way too much skin showing. No hats allowed in the building, no matter how fly it is. Just turn your phone off and put it away, or pay $15 to get it back, which is not worth it. Like I said before, even though the snapbacks fly, you can't wear it in the building. On the cool, sagging is not what's up anymore. Everything is wrong right here. Sagging and wearing a hat, that's just a fail. Ladies, if y'all want to wear skirts, it must be 2 inches above the knee. Sorry. Like I said before, sagging is not cool and it's out of style. Even at lunch, the rules still apply. So Hastings, you've been warned and now you know all the rules.
Achoo!
Ew, Daisy! You're not supposed to sneeze your hand, that's gross!
I think I need German.
Yes, you do! See, this is why everyone is sick. Germs, Deysi, germs.
Sorry, I'm sick.
Check this out.
Let's face it, germs are all around us. In fact, we are filled with germs, and we sometimes do some pretty gross things to pass our germs to others. Take a look at this. Pretty gross, right? That's basically how we catch colds, the flu, viruses, and all kinds of bacterial infections that can really make us sick. So let's stop spreading germs. If you have to cough or sneeze, use your sleeve, the inside of your shirt, or a Kleenex, not your hands. Don't share personal items like lip gloss, makeup, or soda with anyone, not even your BFF. Keep your hands off your face, just think about all the things your hands have touched. Use hand sanitizer, and last but not least, please, please, please wash your hands after you use the restroom. Alright, Hastings, now you know what to do, so do it. This has been Shakira Jack reporting for Bare Network News.
In other news, shout out to all the students participating in Hastings clubs or organizations. It's time to get up and get out and do something. Take a look at this.
Got clubs? Well, Hastings sure does, and there are over 50 for you to join. Some are parts of a class, and some are open to anyone, from anime, to drama, to student council, to video. There's a club or a class for that, so why should you get involved?
Why should students join an organization?
Because Hastings is a big family. We're reflective of Houston, and any way to get involved in any type of society is to participate in the organizations that are present. This is a way where you feel, like I said, involved, and you feel like this is part of your family. We have over 50 extracurricular activities on our campus, so there's something for everyone to do.
Name in your organization?
My name is Shakira Lewis, and I represent Alief Hastings Speech and Debate Team.
Tell me about your organization.
Well, the Speech and Debate Team is a very fun organization that teaches you how to debate and the actual skills to how to act and all that kind of stuff. You know, it's really fun.
What name in your organization?
I'm Kenya Ruiz, and I'm in MCJROTC.
So tell me about your organization.
What we do is we work out. We teach people how to have professional, you know, we teach them how to be professional. We teach them how to grow, and then we give them new opportunities. It's pretty much.
What's your name and the organization you're representing?
My name is Bridget, and I'm in Earth Club.
So tell me about your organization.
What we do is we recycle paper, cardboard, and this year we're helping with the seniors, helping them recycle cans to raise money. We go to UNs across the street and talk to the little kids on Earth Day and tell them, hey, you know, save the Earth. And we fundraise by selling chips to pay for our shirts, and at the we have an end of the year banquet, which is at Cheesecake Factory.
When do y'all meet?
We meet usually on Thursdays, once or twice a month, for around 15, 20 minutes tops.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
What's your name and the organization you're representing?
My name's Chris, and I'm representing National Spanish Honor Society.
So tell me about your organization.
Our organization is based on basically community services for the society and giving back to our community.
When do y'all meet?
We meet every Thursdays almost at the end of the weekend, sometimes every Monday.
Okay, thank you.
Here's my take on this. You are here for 4 years, so you may as well make the best of it, Hastings. You'll make new friends, learn something new, and it looks good on your college applications. Don't talk about it, be about it. Let's get involved, Hastings. This has been Kevin Ho for Bare Network News. Peace out.
And speaking of things to do, it's going to be a mad, mad world during homecoming week. Monday is Twin Day. Dress up like your favorite celebrity on Tuesday. Show everyone your nerdy side on Wednesday. Get your disco gear and bell bottoms ready because Thursday is 70s day. Friday is all black everything, so get your outfit ready for the blackout. And dress to impress Saturday for the homecoming dance. Come on, Hastings. It's time to get live, and it's time to represent. We learned about some interesting people during Hispanic Heritage Month. Let's see what Yesenia has for us this week.
The Hispanic Heritage Person of the Week is soccer player Javier Chicharito Hernandez. Hernandez was born on June 1st, 1988 in Guadalajara, Mexico. Javier is commonly known as Chicharito, meaning little pea in Spanish. His father nicknamed him Chicharo because of his green eyes. Javier is a top soccer scorer in the Gold Cup and is one of the best forwards in the Manchester United soccer team. He's also earned an MVP award. With all of the struggles of his country, Javier Hernandez serves as an inspiration because he's doing something positive with his talents. This has been Yesenia Martinez with your Hispanic Person of the Week.
It's testing time. Seniors will have to take the ASVAB and everyone else will take the PSAT. The PSAT will be Wednesday, October 12th. You will need to be on time because the test begins at 7:20. You can't have electronic devices, so turn them in or leave them at home. Bring a calculator to use on the math portion, and also a sweater because it may be chilly. Go to bed early and eat a good breakfast. And last but not least, the test is timed, so bubble as you go. You won't have time to do this during the test. Good luck, everyone. Well, that's it for this week, Hastings. Remember, stop overreacting to things, cover your cough, and get involved.
Before we go, here are a few things that make us go,
Later, Bears.
Things that make you go,